How are you guys? Good, excellent. So good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's my honor and pleasure to be here this evening to be presenting before you my perspective on honest profit. Honest profit is not just what is legally required, but what is ethically desired. Honest profit in business today is about the triple bottom line. That is financial, social, and environmental, or some of you might say, people, planet, and profit. It's not a daydream, because there are companies who have taken steps in the right direction, but it's far from being an imperative, because there are many who haven't. John Lewis Partnership is a classic example. All employees are partners of the company, have a share in the annual profits, and more importantly, a say in how the business is run. The John Lewis business model fosters a positive psychological contract, high levels of engagement and motivation, organizational commitment, which in turn leads to low employee turnover. John Lewis truly believed that business could put the welfare of people, employees, in the heart of everything it did and still make a profit. This left a mark, a radical mark on commercial history. Another good example is British high street retailer Marks & Spencer, who is leading the way in sustainability through the visionary program Plan A. Plan A, which was launched back in 2007, started with 100 commitments and a pledge to spend £200 million over a span of 5 years. Through Plan A, Marks & Spencers are working with customers and suppliers to combat climate change, trade ethically, use sustainable raw materials, and lead the way for healthy lifestyles. The program itself has given back to the company over £120 million come 2014. Have we all ever realized why companies like M&S are leading the way? Why are they spending the money and trying to make a difference? What's in it for them? Then on a smaller scale, we have companies like PeopleTree that produce beautiful clothes, which doesn't come attached with corruption and exploitation. They help local communities, use organic raw materials, and try to use methods of production that really mitigate the environmental impact. And for the not-so-ethical businesses, Amazon. The negative aspects of Amazon's employment practices have been widely reported. Zero-hour contracts, low wages, stress, it's all over the place. Though the company really provides customers with extreme convenience and near seamless shopping experiences, it does come at a cost. We see the good, we see the convenience, we see the click, and we get this, the item. What we really fail to recognize is how they treat their employees. And Primark, what can I tell about them? April 2013, a factory producing Primark clothes collapsed, taking over 1,100 lives. This highlighted extremely poor and unsafe conditions for workers to be working, no regular inspections when it came from the employer to be functioning in an international market. Child labor and other abuses were reported as well. If that wasn't enough, a few weeks later, another factory associated with Primark blazed out, taking 8 lives. We all, as consumers here, share responsibility for all the tragedies and many more that might happen. When such tragedies happen, it's in the press, it's in the media, we say never again. We feel sad, our hearts ache, we feel shocked. We reach deep into our pockets and try to support the victims. But then, public outrage is really short-lived. Look at the woman who is back to Primark with her bag, even though the protests are on. Why do we do this? By the way, Primark's profit increased by 44% last year. How many cheap clothes do we need? Why not buy clothes from one ethical retailer that's going to last us a while, as opposed to companies like Primark, just to use them, throw them away, and go back to buy more? Not very sustainable, is it? I mean, why should companies even care to be ethical when we as consumers don't? But then some of you might say, we are just individual customers. We can't do much. How can we make a difference? To which I'm going to say, sure you can, and this is how. It wasn't long back that Nike was being shamed in the public for its labor practices to the extent that it really badly tarnished the company's image and hurt the sales. It was during the early 90s that contracted workers of Nike in Indonesia were being treated really badly. Unsafe and poor conditions. They were being paid 14 cents an hour, which during the early 90s was less than the minimum Indonesian wages. Once again, reports of child labor, other rampant abuses emerged. The reform did happen, but it took a long time. Now, unlike back in the days, I'm not telling all of you to go there to the streets, leave what you're doing, your study, your work, and start campaigning. Gone are those days. Today, we have the power, the reach, and the immediacy of social media. When we spend so much time in Facebook blogging, why can't we make a difference to causes like this? Nike did it. We can as well. The ultimate responsibility for honest profit lies with the consumers. We have the power to make the change. Now move on to Starbucks. Back in 2012, it emerged that Starbucks had paid only 8.6 million pounds in corporation taxes in their 14 years of trading in Britain. Nothing at all in the last 3 years. Same story. Public applied pressure, the sales were hurt, and Starbucks paid up. Now, it might sound that Starbucks is trying to do the right thing here by paying the 20 million pound, but hang on a minute. 28.6 million pounds in 14 years of the trading in Britain? That's approximately 2 million pounds per year. And what about now that all the publicity has died down? What's happening now? Now, tax evasion is not illegal. All companies out there try to pay as little taxes as possible. After all, they have shareholders to answer to. But it is unethical because tax evasion affects all of us. It affects the public services, it affects the community. When all of us pay taxes on our modest salaries, does it really seem fine that companies like Starbucks out there are paying so little? Well, that brings us back to where we started. Honest profit, corporate daydream or imperative. We all in this room want to be the leaders of tomorrow. When we finish at Henley, we want to work for companies that we are proud of and really happy to be ambassadors for. What makes a nice leader? What makes a good, strong leader? How many of us are actually even going to be leading by example? Well, I can understand. I mean, we are still in school. We are young. We are students. We cannot do much. We can't take big measures, big gestures. But what we can do here is make some small changes. For example, change our shopping habits. I have never, ever shopped at Amazon or Primark, nor do I intend to do so. It might take me longer to find what I want and where I can go and get it, but I'm going to do my research and spend my money in line with my conscience. The situation is not simple. I mean, the government regulations are not coming anytime soon to force companies out there to make the changes, to change the behaviors when it comes to operating in international markets. But I truly believe we all can make a difference. It isn't black and white either. I mean, these are companies with commercial constraints. They are not charities. But I truly believe, once again, that we as consumers decide what happens here. If we really make a voice, try to attempt for a change, the companies out there, they have to listen. There are companies who listen nothing but when their sales are hurt. And if we can really merge it together and tell them why we are not patronizing the companies, why we are not going there, change is bound to happen. But the question here is, again, are we going to do it? Are we going to make that stand? Are we going to use our social media to better effect to do these changes, talk to the company, engage with them, and tell them? And if yes at all, which is great, are we going to sustain those things? Only then, I believe, can honest profit in true sense become an imperative. Now, on that note, I'm going to leave you all with one last thought. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.